the CSI effect is essentially the idea that almost in every criminal case there's some type of scientific evidence that could be used as some type of proof to either support the claim or to refute the claim. It is a real issue in today's courtroom. The CSI effect is something that should be addressed by the litigants, because if they don't, they are missing an important component, and that is that potential jurors that are coming in from the community are watching these types of shows. We know they are. They're popular within the community. And there is some anticipation, some expectation that from what watching television, from watching these types of shows, that perhaps if this is a similar case to what they've reviewed on TV, that there may be that type of evidence existing. I'm always concerned about whether or not they have some preconceived notions about scientific evidence that causes them to have fixed opinions before they've heard the evidence, evaluated the evidence, and seen the witnesses testify to the evidence. So it is a concern to me, just like any other type of evidence or any type of bias, prejudice, or sympathy that the jurors may have that they cannot set aside in deciding the case. In any individual case, I would suggest that both of them, like well-trained attorneys should do, is to prepare early, and prepare early and anticipate it in every single case that that issue is going to come up. That it's, you have to pay attention to what you know it, the jurors are, or potential jurors are, that may be deciding guilt or innocence in a case. And if you're not, then you're missing it, because we know that those are the types of shows they're watching. And as such, there is at least the anticipation, if not expectation, that this evidence might be addressed in any particular case. In jury selection, most every time there is a jury selection, the prosecutor usually has the first opportunity to talk to jurors about different issues, and almost invariably they bring up the fact of the CSI effect, and it varies upon, their questions vary upon what the issue is in their case and what their evidence is. Typically, the prosecutor asks questions in regards to, do you believe everything that you see on these types of shows? And then the defense attorney will oftentimes ask questions such as, don't you expect the prosecution to bring in any evidence that they have that might support the case? Do you understand it's the prosecution's burden to bring in this evidence? A super majority of the potential jurors raise their hand, indicating that they're watching the typical types of shows where you would see this type of evidence being presented, whether it be what's referred to as the real life TV shows or versus the ones that are somewhat fictional. The jurors oftentimes will kind of sit up in their seat, so to speak, when scientific evidence such as DNA or fingerprint evidence or something of that nature is presented. It seems as though they pay more attention when that type of evidence is presented rather than perhaps lay witness testimony. I think that you have some individuals that are rather well aware of this type of evidence and have a fairly good grasp as to what you can expect to receive in the way of information from this type of evidence. And there are always going to be those that might put overemphasis on it or underemphasize the evidence because they simply don't understand it. I have seen both the prosecutor and the defense attorney work CSI effect type of evidence depending upon what evidence they believe is being presented or should be presented that's not being presented. I think it's pretty equally balanced. I don't think that what I've seen is that one emphasizes it more than the other. Clearly, when there's a lack of physical evidence or lack of scientific evidence, an astute defense attorney is going to bring that up and bring that to the attention of a jury. However, if a prosecutor, which in many cases has some type of scientific evidence, they're certainly letting the jury know about that and what it really means. And if there's a lack of it for some reason, they're spending time explaining why there's a lack of that evidence. It should be something that the litigants use early on in their preparation. They should be preparing ahead of time with questions. Also, especially in jury selection, but in opening statements, I see that they're bringing these types of issues up in direct and cross-examination, in the presentation of their cases, and also in closing arguments. It's really, in a sense, infiltrated the whole process where it should be addressed at all stages. I see that it is being addressed in the trials that I've been presiding over almost in every stage. And I anticipate that's going to continue that way because of the expectations, and the attorneys are aware of this expectation.